are thinking about bouncing them and getting to the corner, but guys are wrestling up too. They have good shot recovery. When they get on the elbow, they start circling up. So right here with the dresser, sometimes we're going to let them rise and they go get them. Same thing with this, but we're going to hit inside trick. Okay? So Justice is down. Alright, we're going to be looking to bounce him, but he gets on my elbow and he's circling up, recovering his position. Now, if you look at the angle, he's circling to this just like he did on our dresser, but instead of coming under, we're going to go in and get inside trip with our right leg. Okay? So I'm bringing him down, he's circling up, right leg is where we're going into our trip. So he's circling into this, he's kind of setting up himself, like really kind of doing the right thing. We're gonna go get him. Now, I don't know if you guys have done much with inside trip, but just want to encourage you, don't overthink it. It's penetration. So if you think about, just stand up right please, like coaches have been showing good penetration, right? Body to the legs and everything, head up, back straight, hips in. Inside trip is just like that, where here's my arm going to his leg, and now it's my leg going to his leg. It's still penetration, it's still attacking, just stand right there. Good, I'm still attacking that space, but here's my penetration, it's this little crow hop. I'm stepping through his legs, right? Now they're just like my hand went through. Anytime you hit a trip though, you're going to throw your head across to the trip side, and the first thing that should connect with the mat is your knee. Never put your toe down, but just step right through this hole. Put your knee down, right? You're committing your hips. If you notice, can you stand up please? If you notice where I'm at with my body position, my head is up, my back is straight, my hips are in, right? Both coaches this morning were talking about head up, back straight, hips in, right? For good leg attack. So everything's the same. Wrestling is wrestling. We're just using our leg instead of our arm, okay? So, a little bit on the technique here. As Justice starts circling to his left, he's kind of giving me the angle. I'm gonna crow hop in. If you watch my footwork, I'm gonna bring my left foot to my right, and then my right foot is going right through the hole, and I'm gonna look to my back heel, all right? To get yourself to understand how to commit your hips and not put that toe down, you wanna be looking back, kind of glance back at your heel, and that will allow you to step through and fully commit your hips on this. We need that, all right? Be in our front hand position, you're bringing him down, he's coming back up, right there. Get him. Notice what I'm doing there with my lock too. I'm again cinching down into that body lock, because we're looking for pins. We did the Turk, we went dresser down, we went cradle, now we're looking inside trip, body lock, get the fall, okay? Just think about that, man. Anyone can be pinned. You can pin anyone, right? If you get in the habit of always drilling, taking down, breaking down, score to a score, looking to put them to their back, I think you're going to find yourself in position to pin more people. And at the very least, as a collegiate wrestler, you know, we have four count for four, for near fall, okay? So you're going to be able to rack up the points. That can be a 6-point lead, which with two very evenly matched quality college wrestlers, 6 points is a lot to come by. So you can get good at some of these feet-to-back techniques, rack up the points, and quickly fall. You're gonna make the transition to collegiate wrestling pretty quick. Any questions on the technique? Let's give it a try. 1, 2, 3.